Our basic self is also the home to our inner child, the living self within us that got stuck around the ages of 4 to 5. The inner child yearns for love and acceptance and carries all our fears and inadequacies, our shame and guilt, the need for approval, respect for authority and feelings of powerlessness, as well as our spontaneity and sense of wonder. If your inner child was told that it was no good at spelling, or don't trust strangers, or you can't have it all, or even life is a struggle, it probably still holds those beliefs today and will strive to confirm those outdated messages. The basic self or subconscious holds our childhood beliefs. It makes no judgment whether the message is either positive or negative and will cling to those beliefs, which means repeating the past. In this meditation, we're going to meet our inner child to find out what they need from our adult self. So finding a place that's comfortable to sit or lie down, with your feet firmly on the floor. Adjusting yourself to get comfortable, we're taking 3 large deep breaths. In through the nose and out through the mouth. And as we breathe, we allow our body to start to relax, loosening the shoulders and allowing any stress or strain of the day just to ebb away. Any thoughts that float in, allow them just to drift on by. And as we breathe, we take our attention down to our feet and feel the floor beneath them. Feel the support you're being given. And as our attention is focused here, our feet might even start to tingle or to warm. Taking in a deep breath in, and as we breathe out, we notice our navy blue roots start to grow from the soles of our feet down into the floor beneath. Push those roots down through the foundations of your home and down into Mother Earth. Pushing those roots further down into Mother Earth of the rich, dark soil. Down deeper and deeper. And down deeper until you see your large granite rock. This granite rock is infused with white quartz crystal. And watch as your roots entwine around your granite rock, grounding your energy to Mother Earth. And as we take a deep breath in, we draw the energy from this quartz crystal back up through the roots. Drawing that energy back up through our roots of Mother Earth. Back up through the roots. Back up through the foundations of our home. Breathing them back. through the floor beneath you and into the soles of your feet. Draw that energy up through your lower legs, up into your thighs, into your hips and buttocks, and then breathe that crystalline energy up through your root chakra of red. Drawing it up through your sacral chakra of orange. Up into the upper abdomen and into the solar plexus of yellow. And then draw it up into the center of your chest and into the heart center of green. Now take your attention to 18 inches above your head, where sits our sun. And as we focus our energy here, the sun energy switches on. As we breathe in, we draw that golden healing protective light down towards the top of our heads. Breathing it down closer and closer. And as it reaches the top of our head, this golden protective healing energy cascades down over the outside of our bodies, down and around and underneath our feet, encasing us in a healing protective golden bubble. Taking your attention back up to the top of your head, and as we breathe in, we draw that golden light down through our crown chakra of violet, drawing it down through our third eye of indigo, throat chakra of blue, and then down into the chest and into the heart center of green, where it merges with the white crystalline energy of Mother Earth. Connecting you now to both Mother Earth and the Divine Source above. Imagine now that you're at the bottom of a cornfield on a bright summer's day. The sky is the most vividest blue you've ever seen, contrasting with the golden colour of the corn. Feel the heat of the sun upon your skin. As the corn lightly dances in the breeze. sky above you. As they break the silence around you, notice if there are any wild flowers growing amongst the corn. And if there are, pick a small bunch . As you're walking through the corn picking the flowers, you look up and notice on a hilly mound a stone tower. Curiosity gets the better of you, and you make your way to the stone tower up the hilly mound. Remember seeing it before, but you know that it is familiar. And as you're walking around the outside, you notice a large wooden door. You try the latch and find that it is unlocked. Opening the door, you step inside. The sunlight hits the stone as it shines through slats made in the rock face. And you notice two stairways, one going up and one going down. You're drawn to the stairway on the left, which leads downwards. You step down onto the first step. Feel drawn to go further. Walking slowly down through the spiraling stairway, the air becomes cooler. The way is lit, so you can see the steps you take, going down, down deeper around the stairwell. Until you step off at the bottom, and in front of you is a corridor. The way is lit, and as you start to walk down the corridor, you notice doorways off to each side of you. I want you to go to the second doorway on your left. Notice any markings that may be on this door, or what colour it is. And holding the latch or handle, slowly open the doorway and enter. to the dim light, but you sense that it is a large room. And as your eyes become clearer, you notice on the wall to your right a large velvet curtain. There is a drawstring to the side, and as you pull the drawstring, the curtain slowly opens. And before you is a large ornate mirror that stretches from floor to ceiling. As you stand in front of this mirror, looking at yourself, you are aware behind your shoulder that a light is beginning to shimmer, almost like a ball of light appearing in the air behind you. As this ball grows larger and touches to the floor, you become aware that you're not alone. You start to see a figure emerge from the light. You see that it is a small child that resembles your younger self. And as your younger self walks and stands beside you, you see its reflection in the mirror looking up at you. This is your inner child. It is time now to reconnect with your inner child. Get down on its level. It may need a hug. It may even want a story. Use this time to ask your inner child what it needs from you. It may want an apology for ignoring it. It may not say anything. It may just want to play. You may just sense what your inner child needs, for it may be shy. Take your time and allow your inner child to open up. around it the posy of flowers that you picked earlier. Closing back up the curtain as your inner child returns to the light. And know that you can visit your inner child anytime you wish, or even when you hear your inner child calling to you. Make your way back out through the door. And start to climb the stairway. And with each step you take, you feel more at peace within you. Until you're at the top, with a large wooden door in front of you. Opening up the door and stepping back out onto the hill. Take our attention back to our heart center and watch as the golden healing protective energy recedes back up out through the heart center, back up through the throat chakra of blue, back up through the third eye of indigo, and back out through the crown chakra of violet. Watch as it flows back up towards the sun, leaving your golden protective bubble intact. And as it reaches the golden sun above, this light switches off. And we take our attention back to the heart center of green. And watch as the white crystalline energy retreats back down through and in through the yellow of the solar plexus. Breathing it back down through the sacral chakra of orange, down through our root chakra of red, and into our hips and buttocks. Watch as it flows back down through our upper thighs, into our lower legs, and down into our feet. Watch as it flows back down through our roots of our feet and back down through the floor beneath us. Watching it flow back through the foundations of our home and down into the rich, dark soil of Mother Earth. It flows down deeper, back through our roots, until we reach our granite rock. this energy flows back into the crystal of our granite rock as our roots re-entwine around the rock, again grounding us back to Mother Earth. Taking in a large deep breath, we become aware of our physical bodies. We become aware of the chair beneath us and the room that we are in. And slowly, when you are ready, bring your attention back to the here and now.